Greetings, fellow hooligans of the internet. Welcome back to another War Thunder video. Today we are playing the T-35. It is a 1.0, battle rating 1.3, Russian heavy tank of doom and gloom. It has three guns, a 76mm cannon, this little guy up here, two 45mm cannons, just like what you find on the BT-5. Well, this is a BT-7, but you get the point. And it's got a bunch of machine guns. Let's see, one machine gun turret, two machine gun turret, and then looks like three coaxial machine guns in the regular turrets. That's really slow in terms of speed. It's got a max speed of 17. Its armor, well, for 1.0, it's pretty good, I guess. I've not played this thing in an actual match yet. Backing it up, we have a BT-7 Twitch Drop variant, meaning he's got this cool enlisted camo, because it was back when enlisted was first starting out, and so you had the Twitch Drops that was, you get stuff in enlisted and in War Thunder. We have the SU-51 T-26E with nice bushings, T-26 First Gewehrturm, don't know what that actually stands for. I'll have to look it up. Anyway, and then the Gaz AAA Dushk. It's got a single 50 cal. And for air, we have the I-15 Biz with rockets, though I might swap them out for bombs later. And because I can, we have the PO-2, otherwise known as the Russian sewing machine. So, or silent deadly, the Night Witch plane. If you know Sabaton, or Sabaton, however you want to pronounce it. Sabaton. Yeah, Sabaton, because in the live concerts they go, Sabaton! Anyway. But anyway. So yeah. Night Witch plane, speedy, maneuverable boy, and then we got a bunch of tanks. So let's go ahead and get in a match. Designated grid zone. Okay then, and we are, of course, in a match full of light tanks. BT-5 that's gonna just roll out, another BT-5 and a Panzer 35T. It's cold. It's going to look a lot like winter. Freezing rain and snow. Glad I got studded tires on my 4x4. Well, I'll let all the light tanks go to C, and I'll go to B. Actually, A. That's... Well, maybe it'd be a good thing if I went to B, because... One, I'm slow, so there's no way I'd be able to capture a capture point. Especially not if I went to one that's got a bunch of light tanks going to it.
Allied forces have captured a zone.
And the enemy's already capturing it. Where is the enemy tank in question? I'm gonna get shot in the side, aren't I?
Enemy forces have captured a zone. Enemy forces have captured a zone.
There's the enemy tank. It's the new Swedish truck. Ah!
Attention to the map!
As I said, I suck at heavy tanks. Oh, and plus we got up tiered to 2.0. That helps.
The enemy's closer to victory.
Oh, how did... Panzer 38T needs some help. Roll in the heavy tanks. You know, for a heavy tank, this thing doesn't really heavy tank. Also, since when did this Frenchy boy have any sort of penetrating power? Why can't I break his dang gun?
Enemy forces have captured a zone.
I mean, it'd help if I could hit the dang. No, and look, he took out my gunner again. Cat! I'm gonna build up a lot of spawn points just by taking hits from this guy. Oh, looks like someone killed him, maybe? Yep. Match will probably be over by the time I get there. Slower than molasses. I could probably land on the A point. Would I be able to take off again? Probably not. Now I know why this thing's called Silent but Dead, why the Night Witch is. I mean, listen, you can barely hear it.
Allied forces have captured a zone.
Oh, no. I mean, this thing is just so slow. Undetected, unexpected, stealth perfected. Aviation, deviation.
Zone.
Let's see, where are some enemies? Enemies. Preferably not an anti-air. Oh, looks like there's one right there by that Panzer IV-C. Let's see, does he kill him before I get there? Yes, he does. Come on, those didn't kill him? Oh, come on, again those didn't kill him?
Enemy forces have captured a zone. Defend the A point. If we don't do something fast, the enemy will win.
Let's see if we can stop this capture. Let's try to land on the A point. That failed. Maybe I can at least spot the enemy. There he is.
Allied forces have captured a zone.
Come on, stop. I have no brakes.
We need to put more pressure on the enemy. They're winning.
Let's see if we can go up this hill and then come back. Nope, I'm gonna strike my prop! PO2! I failed. I cannot do the thing.
This time, the enemy has proven stronger. Withdraw.
Nope. For a heavy tank, this thing doesn't really heavy tank. I might actually swap for my explosive in the 76 shell because this 70, because the armor penetrating shell doesn't really do a whole lot, as you saw with the French boy there in the first round. I mean, good news about this vehicle is that it crosses the dang trenches with no problem. If I could not get up-tiered at all, this thing would be really fun. I mean, it looks like we did pretty well this match. I'm seeing mostly reserve tanks. But I'm not sure how well that will be. Also, I'm not sure. Can I fit through there? I don't know. Hello, BT-5. Oh yeah, I can, with a little modifications, I can fit. Just gotta redecorate the place a little bit. Again, for a heavy tank, this one does not heavy tank. Well, that worked. Okay, there we go. Is that an M3 Lee? Ow. Ow. Up in here type of area.
Another zone captured. We have the advantage.
T-26, no. Oh good, he's dead. Thank you. need at least one more crew member to man one of these turrets. Preferably two. I wish I could get more than one crew member at that. Which turret did it grab? It grabbed the front one. So there's an M3 over here, so he killed one of our friends. So I just gotta find him and hope he doesn't kill me first. Oh, there's a Chinese T-26 that just got hit. Danger! Danger! Wish the 76 gun had some smoke on it so I could just go, hey BT-7, you're gone.
Defend the B point.
Take that. Kill this dang anti-air that yeeted me out of existence. Attack of the trucks. kill my dude.
Yes, revenge! Vengeance is mine.
Granted, it's just a pickup truck with a decal on it, so...
Enemy forces have captured a zone!
Come on, lads! Oh, there's just as much of them as there are of us. There is. Guys, we can do it.
Let's keep the pressure on. Victory is close.
Yes, we win. Okay, so I'm gonna try this ammo. So I've got more ammo in me. Oh, I mean, the penetration's not much different, but it's got more explosive damage. I was going to try just the regular high explosive, but I saw this, I was like, I'll give it a shot. Hey, if I don't like it, I can just swap back, or I'll try out the high explosive next life. I'm probably just mishearing it, but I could have sworn I heard a dang, R3. Look, I know it's not an R3, because an R3 is 4.0. Or is it a 3.7? Or is it a 5.0 now? I don't know. Like, Gaijin messed around with a bunch of the battle rating stuff, and now I don't know. My M36B1, the Italian tank destroyer built off of an American M4 and an American M36, that was a 6.0, and now it's a 5.7. Like, its performance doesn't seem to have decreased any, but it's a lower BR now. Technically speaking, from a certain point of view, its performance increased. got an Italian speedy boy. I've never been so happy to have like three turrets. I mean, it's fairly useful when your tank is as slow as this thing. I mean, this thing and the Po-2 are perfect together because they're just so storming slow. I'm gonna watch this. Okay, that makes sense. Totally. I am not that good with rocket-based weaponry, so forgive me if I miss every single shot. Hey, if I can clear out
enough area, I might be able to...
Like the first match, I might try landing and taking the A point with my plane. I kind of want to build a PO2 replica. Like a... I hear an airplane. I don't see an airplane. I know there's an airplane somewhere. There he is.
Keep it up.
It's a Stuka! That guy took a direct hit and nothing happened? Man, these rockets suck. There's an enemy medium tank trying to shoot me down. He's doing pretty well. Like, he's getting pretty accurate.
Attention to the designated grid zone.
Oh gosh.
Just keep it up, and victory will be ours.
Of course he did better than me. He's got 20 mils. I've only got the 7.62s. Of course, there's not a lot of enemies left to test with. So I won't be able to really see. I'll probably do the ballistics test or go into a test run and see how that works. Although the test drive only gives me German tanks to test. Which, granted, most of the tanks we're up against right now are German, but there are some Japanese and Italian, French. I haven't seen a. Oh wait, is it? I have seen a single French vehicle. There's two French vehicles now, actually. That airplane that killed me. I'll probably not encounter a vehicle before the match ends, which is kind of unfortunate. Because I really wanted to see. Oh, never mind. Hello. That just shows that how bad I am at heavy tanks and how good slash bad this thing is depending on how you take the video. And on that note, that's going to be all for this video. If you enjoy the content of said video, please leave a like, leave a comment. If you enjoy the content of the channel, please consider hitting the subscribe button and notification bell down below. You can always change your mind later. Also, go ahead and check the description below for links to my Discord, my second YouTube channel, and my Reddit and Twitch. Also, guys, thank you for helping me get to where I am in the channel. If I go here and look, I have 74 subscribers, so thank you very much for that. Anyway, have a wonderful day. Bye.